Hey everyone, it's Graphic back with another video, and today we're going to be jumping straight into what we call one of the best ways of leveling in New World. So you're going to see a corrupted portal right in front of us, and you're going to be thinking instantly, yeah, I already know about corrupted portals, they're not that strong. Well, let me talk a little bit more about them today. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys why this leveling process is definitely one of the strongest out there, and why, in my opinion, it's still a very, 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 very relevant way to level in New World. So let's jump straight into it. So like I said, guys, in today's video, we're going to be jumping through the corrupted portals, talking about how they are a relevant way to level very, very quickly. As you saw for just that corrupted portal, which is a minor corrupted portal level 35, I got 632 experience. That's very, very solid because of how long it actually takes. There are faster and slower corrupted portals. This one you're seeing right in front of you now is actually going to be one of the slower corrupted portals, the waves. So you actually have to kill all of the mobs before you get the next wave and so on and so forth. And it goes, I believe, five waves actually that there is, but we'll see here in just a second. But you know, as we talk about corrupted portals, what you're going to want is obviously you can take corrupted tinctures, you can take corrupted coatings, and you can do all of that sort of deal. But you know, when you have this many people that you're seeing here, these are called trains. They have trains of 10 to 15 people, and you just run from portal to portal, really, like I said, making very, very fast progress in character level XP. Like I said, you've probably seen this many, many times. And when people ask if this is a viable or relevant method of leveling, I do really still think this is, like I said, one of the best ways to level. As you can see, I'm level 57. I did do this quite a bit when I was level about 40, 45, and I was doing 35 corrupted portals with about 10 to 15 people. I wanted to go back and just get some of the gameplay for you guys for this video. But, you know, I am doing level 35s here just to get some of that XP, because a lot of you guys are probably within, you know, being able to do 25 to 35 corrupted portals at the very least, and maybe even a possibility at 45s. But when you have this many people, this is probably, like I said, the most important part. You can see this left side, by the way, on the screen here. You can see how many portals there are on the left side of what I believe this is, Weaver's Fen. So if you can find a good spot where there are tons of corrupted portals, you can run with 10 to 15 people. If you just start asking in maybe your faction chat, I'll flag up if you want that extra 10% bonus XP, or you can even, you know, just stay PvE flagged or unflagged, I guess I should say. It's going to be a great way to level. Like I said, I just want to kind of validate that this is still relevant, still a very, very valid way to level. You see a lot of people doing this, higher level 50s, higher level 60s, not 60s, but higher level 40s and higher level 50s, basically seeing you run these trains and corrupted portals. I think we're going to see a lot more of this. We're going to see a lot more people utilize this way of leveling in the upcoming days ahead, as they realize that this is still, like I said, one of the best ways. It's not always going to be town boards. It's not always going to be, you know, the side quests and main quests. You know, main quest is going to be a great way to level. Town boards, huge way to level, but side quests are undervalued right now, in my opinion. They're not undervalued, I guess. They're underutilized because there's not much value in them, is what I should say. Side quests, for the most part, besides Everfalls, are fairly low XP and not really worth doing. And I think a lot of people are going to be focusing a lot more on these corrupted portals, because they don't only give you XP, they give you great Azoth, they give you great territory standing, and they give you those, you know, caches as well, which the caches, by the way, can give you some great items and gear. So just really all around a great way to level, great way to really continue to get ahead of the game. You can see here that I'm actually gathering on the way to the next portal, but I want to kind of show you this specifically because I thought I had time to gather all of this stuff, but because I saw, you know, it was a wave where it was actually one of the longer corrupted portals, or minor corrupted portals, I should say. So I thought I had time, and it does look like I tried to chop this tree, by the way, and now you can actually see that I am unfortunately going to be late to the party when it comes to the XP. I get back in here, and I shoot an arrow. Let's see here. I wanted to just kind of explain how this works. So I shot an arrow, hit one damage on an enemy, basically. I don't even think I hit anything else. Even though I had a group inside of here, I didn't get anything because I was too late to the party. So make sure you're there ahead of time. Make sure you're there. But you can see, like I said, that huge, huge left side of Weaver's Fen has so much. And it's going to depend on the tier of invasion that they're on. So if you actually ever look under the name of these territory, you should be able to see 1, 2, or 3 basically red dots or red invasion symbols. If they're on that third corrupted invasion little symbol, they're going to have the most portals and biggest or most spawn rates. So just keep that in mind as well. But like I said, there's this great, still, like I said, right now, a great valid way to get as much XP as you possibly can, get that Azoth, and also territory standing, which you do need to buy a house in that territory. So it's great to do in a place like Windsward or Everfall if you guys are planning on, you know, buying a house there. And then on way from, you know, Corrupted Portal, you can definitely do some gathering like you see me doing here. It's one of those ways to kind of you take advantage of these, you know, portal runs. You maybe have 10 to 15, 20 people, and you're able to kill these off in very, very, very quick matter of getting 605, I think it was about 620, 630 XP, 605, right around there, depending if you take character XP on the territory standing board, but basically right around there, 600 plus XP for the minor corrupted portals, and that's if you are running those 35s. If you're running the major corrupted portal level 35, it was a little bit over 2.2k XP, I believe. So just keep that in mind for level 35, and you can do these very, very quickly, definitely with big patches, and you can probably shoot about, I would say the miners, you can shoot about 4 or 5 within 5 minutes if they're right next to each other and they're not the waves of enemies. If they're just the tentacles, or if they're just the, you know, there's a couple different ways to take advantage of the speedy ones, but you know, if they're just the tentacles, then you're going to be able to do 4 or 5 within 5 minutes very, very easily if they're right next to each other, which most of the time on a three corrupted portal, or I guess the three corrupted invasion star, or whatever you want to call it, territory, you know, it is that quick. So I just wanted to kind of basically, like I said, validate corrupted portals, thinking that, you know, a lot of people are not really taking advantage of them. It's something to definitely take advantage of in this game. Definitely get a team in your faction and just go into faction chat, see if somebody else is willing to start something up. Or if you're in a big company, definitely grab some people and try it out. You'll eventually probably add more and more people as people see that you know, you are running those portals. So thanks again for tuning in. Make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, turn notifications on. And by the way, guys, if you didn't know, I do stream on Twitch. So that's going to be twitch.tv/iGraphicGuy. Thank you all for tuning in. I'll see you guys all on Eternum.